In the skies over Moscow in 1997 emerged an aircraft unlike any other, with wings swept forward at a striking 20-degree angle, giving it a unique profile seemingly defiant of aerodynamic logic. The Sukhoi Su-47 Berkut shocked observers and sent ripples through the global aviation community. This wasn't just an experimental prototype, it was a glimpse into a possible future of air combat that challenged fundamental assumptions about fighter design. The Su-47 represented the culmination of decades of Soviet and Russian aeronautical research, even managing to survive the collapse of the USSR. It promised unprecedented maneuverability, which had the potential to radically transform dogfighting tactics, maintaining control at extreme angles of attack far beyond the capabilities of conventional fighters. Incorporating advanced composite materials, the Berkut was a flying laboratory that would influence the nation's next generation of fighters. The story of the Su-47 Berkut is one of bold innovation, engineering challenges, and the relentless pursuit of aerial superiority. This is the tale of Russia's most revolutionary fighter, the Golden Eagle that dared to fly against the wind. The story of the Su-47 Berkut began in the early 1980s against the backdrop of renewed Cold War tensions. As both the United States and the Soviet Union sought to assert dominance through increasingly advanced military technology, the Soviet leadership issued a directive in 1983 for the development of a new breed of fighter, equivalent to the American Advanced Tactical Fighter, or ATF. This new aircraft was to be not just a response to their rivals' fourth-generation fighters like the F-15 Eagle and F-16 Fighting Falcon, but a leap beyond them. The Sukhoi Design Bureau, with its rich history of creating successful fighter aircraft, took up this ambitious challenge. Under the leadership of Mikhail Simonov, the Sukhoi team envisioned an aircraft that would redefine the boundaries of fighter performance. Their answer to the ATF directive would become the Su-47 Berkut, an aircraft embodying the most radical and innovative concepts in aeronautical engineering of its time. From the outset, Sukhoi focused on incorporating cutting-edge technologies and unconventional design elements into the Su-47. The most striking of these was the decision to use a forward-swept wing configuration. This choice was influenced by earlier research conducted by the Central Aero-Hydrodynamic Institute, which had studied captured German Junkers Ju 287 aircraft from World War II and recognized the potential benefits of forward-swept wings. Interestingly, across the ocean, the United States was also exploring forward-swept wing technology with the Grumman X-29 experimental aircraft. However, while the X-29 remained purely a technology demonstrator, Sukhoi aimed to develop the Su-47 into a combat-capable fighter. The Su-47's development leveraged several recent advancements in aerospace engineering. Innovations in material science allowed for the use of composites in airframe construction, offering superior strength-to-weight ratios compared to traditional metals. Sukhoi also incorporated the emerging concept of supermaneuverability into the Su-47's design, aiming to create an aircraft that could maintain effectiveness beyond conventional stall limits. Additionally, the advent of fly-by-wire systems allowed for the development of an inherently unstable yet highly agile airframe, a characteristic deemed essential for the next breed of combat aircraft. However, the development process was far from smooth. The project faced its greatest challenge with the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991. The ensuing economic turmoil led to severe budget cuts in military programs, and many ambitious projects were canceled outright. Yet the leadership at Sukhoi, recognizing the potential of their design, made the bold decision to continue development using the company's own limited resources. This period of financial uncertainty slowed progress, but also spurred innovation. The Sukhoi team had to find creative solutions to technical problems with limited funds, often relying on computer simulations and theoretical work when full-scale testing was not possible. This approach, while born of necessity, would later prove beneficial in refining the aircraft's design. Throughout the 1990s, work on the Su-47 continued in relative secrecy. The aircraft's existence was not officially acknowledged until 1996, causing a stir in the international aviation community when it was finally revealed. After nearly 14 years of development, overcoming numerous technical challenges and financial hurdles, the first Su-47 prototype was completed in 1997. The Su-47 Berkut was a marvel of aeronautical engineering. incorporating numerous innovative features that set it apart from conventional fighter designs of its era. At the heart of its unique capabilities was its most distinctive feature, the forward-swept wings. The wings of the Su-47 were swept forward at an angle of approximately 20 degrees. This unconventional configuration was chosen for several significant advantages that Sukhoi's engineers believed would give the aircraft unprecedented performance in air combat scenarios. One of the primary benefits of the forward-swept wing design was its enhanced maneuverability. At high angles of attack where traditional swept-back wings would experience airflow separation leading to a stall, the forward-swept design maintained attached airflow. This characteristic allowed the Su-47 to maintain control and maneuverability in extreme flight conditions, potentially giving it a decisive edge in close-range air combat, where the ability to outmaneuver an opponent could mean the difference between victory and defeat. The forward-swept configuration also offered an improved lift-to-drag ratio. This aerodynamic advantage translated into better energy efficiency for the aircraft during high-performance maneuvers. In practical terms, this meant the Su-47 could potentially maintain higher energy states during dogfights, allowing it to sustain aggressive maneuvers for longer periods or recover more quickly from high-stress flight conditions. Furthermore, the forward sweep design shifted the center of lift forward on the aircraft, enhancing its longitudinal stability and control. This characteristic promised to make the Su-47 more responsive to pilot inputs and potentially easier to control in a wide range of flight conditions, from low-speed, high-angle-of-attack maneuvers to high-speed interceptor roles. However, these benefits came at a cost. The forward-swept configuration placed enormous stress on the wing structure, particularly at high speeds. To counteract this, Sukhoi engineers employed advanced composite materials, including carbon fiber and titanium alloys, in the wing construction. These materials accounted for up to 13% of the aircraft's structure, a significant proportion for its time. The Su-47's fuselage was equally innovative. Measuring 74 feet 2 inches in length, it featured a blended wing body design that reduced overall drag and improved aerodynamic efficiency. The smooth contours and carefully shaped surfaces were also designed to minimize the aircraft's radar cross-section, although the Su-47 was not a true stealth aircraft. Complementing the forward-swept wings were canards, small foreplanes mounted just behind the cockpit. These canards worked in concert with the main wings to enhance maneuverability and provide additional lift during high-angle-of-attack maneuvers. The Su-47 also featured an all-moving vertical tail, further enhancing its agility. The landing gear was another area of innovation. The Su-47 employed a tricycle landing gear system with a steerable nose wheel designed for operation from rough airfields, a common requirement for Soviet-designed military aircraft. The main landing gear retracted into the fuselage, contributing to the aircraft's clean aerodynamic profile. Powering this marvel were two Lyulka AL-31F turbofan engines, each capable of producing 18,700 pounds of thrust in military power, increasing to 29,800 pounds with afterburner. These engines were chosen to give the Su-47 a top speed of Mach 1.6 at high altitudes and allow it to supercruise, maintain supersonic flight without an afterburner, a capability crucial for modern air combat. The Su-47's cockpit was state-of-the-art for its time, featuring a glass cockpit with multifunction displays and a head-up display. The aircraft was equipped with a fly-by-wire control system, essential for managing the inherent instability of the forward-swept wing design. This system allowed the Su-47 to perform extreme maneuvers that would be impossible for a human pilot to control manually. While the Su-47 was primarily a technology demonstrator, it was designed with combat capability in mind. It featured an internal weapons bay to maintain its low radar cross-section, capable of carrying a variety of air-to-air and air-to-ground munitions. External hardpoints were also available for additional weaponry or fuel tanks, albeit at the cost of increased radar visibility. On September 25, 1997, the Su-47 took to the skies for the first time, piloted by Igor Votantsev. The maiden flight was a success, validating many of the theoretical principles behind the Su-47's unique design. However, it also marked the beginning of an intensive testing phase that would reveal both the strengths and limitations of this revolutionary aircraft. Initial flight tests focused on basic handling characteristics and flight envelope expansion. Test pilots, including Votantsev, reported that the aircraft demonstrated exceptional agility and control, particularly at low speeds and high angles of attack. The forward-swept wings prove their worth, allowing the Su-47 to maintain stable flight in conditions that would cause conventional aircraft to stall. As testing progressed, the Su-47 was pushed to ever more extreme maneuvers. It demonstrated the ability to perform tight turns with a radius about 20% smaller than that of conventional fighters. The aircraft could maintain control at extreme angles of attack that could potentially revolutionize air combat tactics. However, the testing phase also revealed some limitations of the design. The complex aerodynamics of the forward-swept wings resulted in higher drag at supersonic speeds compared to conventional swept-back designs. This limited the Su-47's top speed and range, factors that would be crucial in actual combat scenarios. The use of composite materials in the wing structure, while necessary to manage the extreme forces, presented its own challenges. These materials were prone to stress cracks, requiring frequent inspections and potentially increasing maintenance costs in an operational environment. Throughout the testing process, Sukhoi engineers made numerous modifications and refinements to the aircraft. The fly-by-wire system was continually updated to optimize the Su-47's handling characteristics. Aerodynamic tweaks were made to improve performance and address issues discovered during flight tests. In 1999, the Su-47 made its public debut at the Max Air Show, stunning observers with its unconventional design and impressive flying display. This public reveal sparked intense interest in the international aviation community and speculation about the aircraft's capabilities. Despite the promising results of the flight test program, the Russian Air Force ultimately decided not to pursue the Su-47 for production. The complex engineering required for the forward-swept wing configuration, coupled with the high costs of development and potential maintenance challenges, made the aircraft less attractive as a frontline fighter. However, these benefits came at a cost. The forward-swept configuration placed enormous stress on the wing structure, particularly at high speeds. To counteract this, Sukhoi engineers employed advanced composite materials, including carbon fiber and titanium alloys, in the wing construction. These materials accounted for up to 13% of the aircraft's structure, a significant proportion for its time. In the years following its initial testing phase, the Su-47 was used to evaluate various systems and technologies that would later find their way into other Russian aircraft. These included advanced flight control algorithms, new sensor systems, and improvements in composite material applications. The Su-47 made several appearances at the Max Air Show throughout the late 1990s and 2000s, showcasing Russia's continued prowess in aerospace engineering. Surprisingly, after a long absence from the public eye, the Su-47 made an unexpected reappearance at the Max Air Show in 2019. This display, more than a decade after it was thought to have been retired, reignited interest in the aircraft and speculation about its ongoing role in Russian aerospace research. Although the forward-swept wing configuration was not adopted for production aircraft, many of the technologies and design principles tested on the Su-47 influenced future Russian fighters. The Su-35, for instance, incorporated lessons learned from the Su-47's thrust vectoring experiments and high angle of attack performance. The Su-57 benefited from the composite material research and radar cross-section reduction techniques explored in the Su-47 program. The Su-47 also had an impact beyond Russian borders. Its development spurred renewed interest in forward-swept wing designs among aviation engineers worldwide, leading to further research and experimentation with this unconventional configuration. Today, it is believed that the sole Su-47 prototype resides at the Gromov Flight Research Institute near Moscow, a silent reminder of an ambitious project that dared to reimagine the future of air combat. Its legacy lives on in the advanced technologies and design principles it helped to pioneer, influencing a new generation of Russian fighter aircraft. The Su-47 Berkut may not have changed the course of military aviation as its designers had hoped, but it undoubtedly left an indelible mark on the history of flight. It remains a symbol of the relentless pursuit of technological advancement that continues to drive the aerospace industry forward.